Welcome to Tales from SYL Ranch, the BitChute channel where everyone is entitled to my opinion, and I'm Bill Stone. While I have your attention, I'd like to ask that if you like what I'm doing, please like this video, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, share me on social media, and tell all of your friends, family, neighbors, pets, and livestock to do the same. I'd appreciate your support via my PayPal tip jar, my Subscribestar, my merch store on Teespring, or a place on my website where you can support me further, and there are links to all of these in my description box. Amazingly, I can say something now that I never thought that I'd ever hear myself say. Ladies and gentlemen, you're looking at a terrorist. That's right, I, William Robert Stone III, am a domestic terrorist. This is because a few hours ago, San Francisco's Board of Supervisors named the National Rifle Association as a domestic terrorist group. Well, guess what? I am a proud, literally card-carrying, life member of the National Rifle Association. And this was a Christmas gift from my father, and no small gift, I might add. This thing costs $1,500. By branding the NRA as a domestic terrorist organization, this makes me a domestic terrorist for life. Screw you, San Francisco. You do know that you have been described as a literal cesspool, right? And I'm being kind in my choice of words there. You do know that you have so many homeless that they dump human excrement on your streets faster than you can clean it up, right? You do realize that drug users dump their government-issued syringes and needles in the streets faster than you can clean it up, right? You do realize that tourists are turning away from a once beautiful city and telling all their friends what a cesspool it's become, right? Now, I myself have some very fond memories of San Francisco. My ex-wife and I visited it for several days on our honeymoon in 1991. I remember a beautiful city, one where with a lot of historical landmarks. I mean, for God's sake, the Golden Gate Bridge. Anywhere we went, we were perfectly safe to walk around at night. And there was the Fisherman's Wharf, which, God, you know, all kinds of stuff to see there and some of the best seafood that I've ever had. But now, I will never visit San Francisco again in my life. Firstly, I don't want to tarnish some very fond memories I have with the cesspool that the city has now become. But more than that, I want nothing to do with a city that would brand me as a terrorist. You're also a major center for some of the top minds in information technology. And I was in that field for 40 years. And you can be sure that I will be screaming loudly to anyone I know to use no products nor services produced by San Francisco and its surrounding communities. Now, Cisco may rule the world in terms of networking at the moment, but I will be telling all of my network admin friends not to use them and use the competitors' products instead. I mean, hell, if I had the seed money, I'd start a competitor. Because you want to know a dirty little secret? In the 1990s, Intel made routers that were easier to use than Cisco's. We lost them in a little backdoor agreement that they had with Cisco where they would stop manufacturing routers. But anyone in networking knows that the interface for the Cisco routers is really complex. In fact, Cisco makes quite a bundle every year by certifying people so that they can use the damn things. In fact, the certified Cisco Network Associate is one of my own certifications. Now, if the user interface for Windows can be called user-friendly, and if we call, say, the MS-DOS or Linux command lines user-unfriendly, the Cisco interface can only be described as user surly. Well, Cisco has competitors, and I'm going to do my level damn best to see that all the contacts that I've made in the course of 4 decades choose something else. Oh, and Google and Facebook, by the way, they can simply frack themselves. We're better off without their communist election interference. And you know what else must be done? California, at least the coasts from San Diego to San Francisco, need to be expelled from the United States. Unfortunately, there's no constitutional way to do this, so it must be accomplished in 2 phases. First, there must be 2 separate states, one for the coasts and one for the rest of the state, There's no reason to punish the people outside of the metro areas for the coast's behaviors. Now, I suggest that we let the coast keep the name California as the name of their new nation, and the rest of the state can become Jefferson. That would be a great addition, and it would be symbolic as hell to anyone who knew their history. Secondly, what's left of California must voluntarily secede from the United States. When you do, by the way, we're going to make sure that we clear out all those military bases, especially the naval ones, and then we're going to bomb them to smithereens. There's absolutely no reason to leave behind any of that military hardware for use by an obviously hostile force. I would then actually support building a wall between California and the new state of Jefferson. A real wall. We don't let anyone in, and we don't want anyone out. We quarantine California. Coastal California is a contaminant to the rest of the United States. Whatever California does tends to bleed over into the rest of the Union. And when its residents leave, as they're doing now in droves, they tend to take their socialist and communist values to their new states. Rather than learning the local culture and integrating, they insist on destroying those states with the culture that destroyed coastal California. The rest of us need you gone, and we need you gone now. So quickly, before the next election, get to work on it. Break it into two states and then secede. You can probably do it in a single day with two short pieces of legislation. I promise there will be no civil war this time. You are absolutely free to leave, and don't let the door hit your ass on the way out. Until then, I'm going to wear my NRA cap, which, by the way, I inherited from my late father. And I will keep carrying my NRA life member card in my wallet. I'll also proudly proclaim that I'm a terrorist. I will wear it as a badge of honor, considering that it came from the communist cesspool of San Francisco. For that matter, I could add some merch on my Teespring store. You know, t-shirts, coffee mugs, basically anything on which I can print the words, I'm a domestic terrorist. I bet I'll make a bundle, considering that there are something like 14 million NRA members. So I'm a domestic terrorist. When you want to see a domestic terrorist, all you need to do is watch my show. And that is all that I have to say about that. I would love to keep the conversation going, so please leave your comments, questions, and nasty remarks, and I'll do my best to respond to you. So that's all the time that we have today for this episode of the highly acclaimed, world-renowned Tales from SYL Ranch, the BitChute channel, where everyone is entitled to my opinion. And I'm domestic terrorist Bill Stone.
Ultimate power in this world has always been one simple thing: the control and manipulation of minds.